Good afternoon, and welcome to the 2015 BAI Infosys Finacle Global Banking Innovation Awards. My name is Holly Hughes. I'm the Chief Marketing Officer at BAI and your host for today's event. Today we gather to recognize and celebrate financial services organizations from around the world that are moving the industry forward with their dedication to drive positive change. These companies possess the passion, discipline, and resources necessary to develop and bring to market revolutionary innovations that are making a difference for consumers, businesses, and communities. And what better place to do that than BAI Retail Delivery, the industry's premier retail banking conference, where leaders from around the world gather to gain actionable insights and make meaningful connections. BAI is proud to have partnered with Infosys Finacle for the last 5 years, providing a platform to showcase and celebrate innovative financial services organizations that are truly transforming the industry. Now, you may have wondered how we got to this point and what the process is for the Global Innovation Awards. Earlier this year, we conducted a global call for nominations, resulting in more than 250 submissions from 130 financial services organizations representing more than 34 countries, all vying for innovation awards in the categories that you see on the screen. This year, we've also added 3 new categories to reflect the changes that are going on within retail banking. And those new awards are Innovation in Payments, the most innovative non-bank financial services organization, and the most innovative community-based banking organization. Now, today's awards would not be possible without our amazing group of judges, and we're so glad to have a number of you here today. Over the course of the past 2 months, they reviewed and evaluated nominations and determined category finalists. They were really used 2 criteria when they were looking at all these wonderful nominations that came in. They looked at originality, and then they also looked at the impact to the consumer and the financial services organization overall. The expertise and experience of this group is really critical in helping us evaluate and determine today's award winners. So now I'd like to take a moment to thank our judging panel. They are Abanti Benerjee, Head of Digital Channels at ICICI Bank, Matt Kallman, Managing Director, Kallman & Company, Ed Carell, Head of Commercial Transformation, Barclays, Bill Hippensteel, Chief Content Officer at BAI, Dr. Jan Hendrik Kraus, former General Manager, Group Strategy, Emirates, NBD, Adrian Lee, Deputy Chief Executive, the Bank of East Asia, Steve Monahan, Regional Director, Head of Edge, AIA, David Passavent, Senior Vice President, Banking Innovation Center Director at PNC Bank, and Gustava Vinacqua, Innovation Center and Open Innovation Director at BBVA. For our judges who are here today, could you please stand so that we can acknowledge and recognize you? You can find more information about the judging panel and today's awards within the program book that was on your chair when you arrived today. Now, one of the advantages of hosting this Global Innovation Awards is that we really gain a lot of valuable insights and trends that are impacting the industry. So we'd like to share some of this information with you via a panel discussion. The panel discussion today will feature 4 great leaders within the industry: Amit Dua, Vice President and Regional Head, Advanced Markets and Global Accounts at Infosys Finacle; 2 members of the Innovation Judging Panel that I mentioned earlier, David Passavent and Ed Carell. And to moderate today's panel, we have BAI President and CEO, Debbie Bianucci. Please join me in welcoming Amit, David, Ed, and Debbie to the stage.
Thank you to all of you for being with us this afternoon. There's so many things going on at BAI Retail Delivery. This is one of our favorite parts because it is an opportunity, as Holly said, to be able to celebrate innovation. And we know that financial services companies recognize the importance of this, but our challenge to be able to innovate in this regulated environment in a way that can move the needle with customers. There's a mounting pressure to have to move faster, to be able to do things more quickly with more relevance to your customer base. We heard some of that as we were talking with the sharks this morning in the session and through some of the summit sessions this afternoon. This awards program was designed a number of years ago to give us the opportunity to surface innovation, to share with you in a way that you might not otherwise be aware of. And it's different in many respects from other awards that you might be aware of, and that's because it's a rigorous review that looks at not only quantitative results, but also qualitative impact on the business. And it is because of the judging panel that we have a very rigorous review of the way in which the finalists are chosen and ultimately the winners who will be announced today. So I'm so pleased to have this panel here, and we'd like to spend a few minutes talking about a few of the things that we saw this year as we were evaluating the nominations that came in and some of the trends that we're seeing in innovation. So I think I'd like to start first with David. If you could give us some of your perspectives about the trends that you saw in the awards this year, perhaps different from last year.
Sure. So we obviously spent a lot of time debating these things. We have a series of calls throughout the year. I would say the consensus was we didn't have anything this year that was totally out of left field, you know, something that just was completely different than anything we'd seen before. What we did see was a lot of very meaningful advancements and themes that have been around the industry for quite a while. So things that we're all very familiar with around themes like omni-channel experience, mobile-first banking. And some of those are highlighted in some of the finalists and winners today. But a couple of that stuck out to me that I would say I expect will heat up even over the next year. One is the concept of open ecosystems and open APIs, and we're seeing this start to gain a little bit of momentum in Europe. But I think that will make its way to the US, even as startups in the US start to open up their ecosystems for incumbent banks to work with them. So that was one trend that showed up in one of the nominations this year. I expect that will continue. The second one is, at least in the US, you know, we're fortunate to be such a hub of startup innovation. And we had several great startups apply this year as we added the category for the non-traditional FI. I think you'll start to see more incumbent banks, incumbent players forming meaningful partnerships with these startups. So rather than just a sort of we want to come and disrupt or eat your lunch, I think you'll see more meaningful ways to sort of collaboratively innovate. So those are two.
And it is a new category this year where we were able to identify some very interesting innovation that occurred in startups. Ed, you have such an interesting background. You've been based in really all regions of the world, so you have a knowledge of what's happening globally that might be different than some of the other judges. What trends did you see this year that stood out to you?
Well, I think I think we saw a number of organizations finally cracking and getting sort of critical mass and momentum on things that have been tried at various times over the last, 5 years or more. And to an extent, it was people solving the problem with the customer around the digital channel and getting enough momentum and critical mass to finally get past those hurdles that have been the way for a long time. I think we also see that those in Asia, in Eastern Europe, as you head south through Europe, there's a lot of truly innovative go-to-market strategies starting to land, and really a challenge back on them, maybe the banks in Northern Europe and in the United States around the agility and the speed with which these Asian and Eastern European banks are working now.
What do you think is making the difference? What stands out?
I think they're less encumbered by legacy. One of the areas that I think we talked about during the panel discussions was there's this huge opportunity for innovation around escaping legacy platforms, legacy infrastructure, which inhibits the incumbent, many large incumbent banks. And you just see this huge differential between those who are on more modern app stacks or who are already operating, you know, cloud native. And I think that's going to be an area where something has to give very quickly. Otherwise, you know, there'll be a huge competitive advantage for the new
I'm
guys.
I'm guessing people in the audience know exactly what you're describing because yeah. It's a reality. Amit, you've done an extensive amount of work in partnering with financial services companies around the globe. What are some of the regional differences that you're seeing?
Actually, very interesting regional differences. So we've had the opportunity to work with close to 185 odd banks around the world. And we also do annual survey jointly with EFMA for last 5 years now. And there are clear differences in the kind of innovation happening in US, Europe, and Australia vis-a-vis the developing world. And we notice that while the US, Europe, Australian banks are innovating around the channel space, the mobile, the internet, the customer front office, you know, wherever there's customer touch points, that's where the innovation is happening. Just as an example, in Australia, there's a bank wherein they've come up with an app where I can click a picture of a property that I'm interested in on my mobile phone, and I will be thrown up with the data of all the properties in the region and the rental yields and how the property prices have gone up, et cetera, et cetera. So the bank has really put the customer at the center of the universe in the truest sense of the term. And you know, you'd stop going to a Google search and go straight to that app for that, right? While in the developing world, we are seeing that most of the innovation is happening around the back office renewal because it's about understanding the customer better before actually attempting to service him on the channels. So those are the clear differences that we are seeing in the two worlds.
Interesting. David, you have innovation responsibilities in your bank, and you had a bird's eye view with the hundreds of nominations that came in through the awards. Mm-hmm. What's your perspective about innovation in U.S. banks, and how does that compare to other regions of the world as mm-hmm. you see it?
Mm-hmm. So I would echo Ed's comments about the opportunities afforded you when you're starting from scratch, basically, from a systems perspective and process perspective are tremendous, right? And so for banks like mine, like at large banks, incumbent banks in the US, the environment that you're innovating in is very restrictive. And I think, so what I would say is, in the US, large banks are trying to figure out how to pull in pieces of technology, process, design, customer experience, either, again, by directly partnering or by building themselves on top of their legacy infrastructures. When I look at the rest of the world, I mean, you see many very exciting things where in a short period of time, someone can take an idea and build it on a new stack of technology, right? And then deliver it, right? So that is happening in the US, I just think, less so, right? So in the US, that's mostly driven by either small banks that can completely outsource, right? Or by startup companies that are disrupting. So that's what I'd say. I think that will continue. I think that big banks are figuring out how to bring in some of the best pieces of what's happening in startups and in other parts of the world. But it's very, very difficult for us to do, right? Mm-hmm. We're learning.
Well, Ed, one of the common themes that we saw as part of the nominations again this year is the importance of building a culture of innovation, that whether it starts at the top or it permeates the entire organization, there's a commitment to and a culture that values innovation. What do you think are the drivers of making that work in a financial services company?
Wow. It's really, really hard. So I think a lot of organizations have set up innovation cells, separate units, and have gone around trying to build a new culture there, bringing in people, getting the incentives right, giving the way of working, whether it be through you know, true agility in the proper sense of the word, or or an environment of work cells and rapid innovation. They've tried that, but as those grow, the antibodies come out and try and kill it and slowly kill it. And I think that's been an experience of so many different banks in so many different regions. People have worked with accelerators or incubators, sometimes at arm's length, sometimes over the wall, and then brought that back inside, or indeed not brought back inside. So I think it is, my wow comment is, I'm not sure anyone's really got it right yet. I think the way banks have operated, the margins they've traditionally operated on, has allowed or has supported a culture of really P&L management. And P&L management and true innovation are challenges with each other. If I'm looking fundamentally at my revenue over the quarter, over the half year, over the year, versus looking at some of true digital companies who are looking at user base, growth, and then monetization, it's a real challenge. Mm-hmm. So I haven't quite answered your question because I wish I knew the answer.
Yeah. It's a very hard thing to do. I know many of your organizations are trying to figure it out and knowing that it could make such a difference, and yet it's so hard to do. I mean, when you think about the banking organizations that you've worked with, and you think about the areas where innovation can really move the needle for their performance, what are the areas that you think are the best places to focus?
That's a hard question. I mean, it's almost an antithesis or counterintuitive to, I mean, if one knew where the innovation or disruption is going to come from, it wouldn't be disruptive anymore in some sense of the word. But, you know, we see that a lot of it is happening on the client interaction and know your customer space. A lot of banks especially trying to get deep customer insights. I mean, just imagine a scenario where I'm a customer of your bank, PNC, and I've applied for a mortgage this morning. You're granting me the mortgage, and in parallel in the evening, I'm doing a Twitter or on my Facebook, I say I'm packing my bags off to Australia next week. Now, does your bank know that I'm going to take a loan and then I'm going to migrate? Now, so are you harnessing the structured data with the unstructured data to get customer insight? And that's where a lot of innovation is going in at the moment.
I'd like to point out that they both acknowledged I ask very hard questions. So this stuff is hard, right? Well, we have time for one more question. And so, David, I'm going to ask you, having been a judge now for mm-hmm. several years, mm-hmm. if you were going to give the audience advice about what to consider in nominating innovation for next year, mm-hmm. what advice would you give?
One thing that sticks out to me every year is innovation is very organization-centric, so each place does it differently, and each entity produces something that's unique to them. So I would say, nominate the thing that you're most passionate about, most proud of, right? And Barbara made those comments very well this morning. It doesn't have to be something that is so completely different, it's never been seen before, but if you really have managed an execution, right, differently, highlight that, right? Highlight even those small things. But again, I would just say let your passion come through, right? Many folks take the opportunity to really highlight how the organization supported them in the process, and so we're very interested to see that as well.
Right? Well, when we recognize and celebrate innovation, it not only helps you because you can see what other banks are doing and other financial services companies are doing to innovate, but it also helps show that our industry as a whole is doing more to innovate to serve our customers. And so there's great value in it on many levels. And so we hope that we'll see more nominations from all of you in the audience next year. I'd like to take a minute just to thank the three of you for being part of the panel. We've enjoyed your comments very much. Thank you.
Amit, you're actually going to stay on stage and help us out with the much anticipated presentation of awards. Is everyone ready for that? David and Ed, thank you so much for your participation in the panel. All right, so our first award is for Product and Service Innovation. We received 80 nominations from financial services companies with a new product or service that has engaged customers, created new revenue opportunities, or improved the bank's market competitiveness. Let's take a look at our finalists.
The finalists for the Product and Service Innovation Award are the Bank of East Asia Limited for Supreme Gold Revitalization. As part of its strategy to attract young and wealthy customers, especially professionals, the Bank of East Asia has revitalized its premium wealth management service, Supreme Gold. This enhanced solution combines the bank's self-developed digital devices with professional services, competitive products and offers, expert staff, and an entirely new look and feel. These solutions are housed in the new Supreme Gold Centers, conveniently located in key shopping hubs. Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce for the Tim Hortons Double Double Visa Card. A first of its kind, all-in-one, two-button technology, combining a no annual fee CIBC Visa credit card with a Tim Cash Rewards card. Cardholders simply press the CIBC Visa button to pay for daily purchases with 1% of each dollar spent instantly converted to Tim Cash Rewards. A simple touch of the Tim Card button enables cardholders to redeem Tim Cash Rewards. The card offers the convenience of Visa PayWave, added security of chip and PIN technology, automatic purchase security, and extended protection insurance. Desjardins Group for Cloud Solution for Payments and Treasury. The Cloud Solution for Payments and Treasury enables Desjardins corporate clients to process domestic and cross-border payments from any enterprise resource planning ERP system to their banks worldwide, regardless of the file format. The solution includes features such as cash and liquidity management, real-time payment processing, automatic account reconciliation, payment investigation, sanction screening, audit and control, as well as risk management tools. Fedor Bank AG for Fedor Smart Current Account. A free bank account built around an application programming interface, the Fedor Smart Current Account supplements classic account services with internet payments and innovative banking products. The open financial ecosystem provides app partners the ability to continuously increase the range of products and services and enables customers to select products and services they want. Features include credit transfers via Twitter, social lending, social trading, and virtual currencies. BankSmart by FM Bank PBP SA for BankSmart. Designed as a digital bank and mobile first, BankSmart addresses financial needs of the new generation of mobile Europeans who benefit from borders-free continent. Customers don't have to open numerous bank accounts in different countries, but can efficiently manage their finances in multinational perspective within one mobile application. BankSmart is the first bank to provide a borderless banking both in Poland and the Eurozone, integrating the two currency personal accounts, providing European money transfers, bill payments, VPay debit cards, and worldwide money withdrawals free of charge.
All right, and the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Product and Service Innovation Award goes to Fedor Bank. I would like to invite Karsten Liu, Vice President of Fedor Group International, to accept his award.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It is truly a pleasure to accept this award on behalf of Fedor Bank today, especially in such a vibrant and exciting city like Las Vegas. To some people, Las Vegas is a gambler's den full of suspicious characters. But it's pretty interesting because you could say the same about some of our traditional banks as well. As a result of the most recent financial crisis, we realized that the world needs an alternative to the traditional bank. So we set out to build the world's first Web 2.0 bank in Germany, headed by Matthias Kroner. Fedor Bank is the first direct bank for the digital age of social networks. We practice what we call social banking. Openness, transparency, customer participation, all are paramount to what we do. We've designed an account that integrates a lot of the popular features of traditional banks, such as credit transfers, as well as new features, such as trading of precious metals and foreign currencies, P2P transfers, crowdfunding, social banking, and international remittances. Additionally, just in August, we launched a new card, the first of its kind in Germany. It combines a traditional MasterCard, the Maestro standard, which is popular across Europe, and contactless payments to create a truly robust card. So we're working hard to try and be a leader in innovation in banking. We regard this award less as a confirmation of our past success, and more as an encouragement to continue deploying our strategy consistently. We believe that there is truly a more honest and direct alternative to the traditional bank, one that puts the customer at center stage. And that's what we mean by social banking. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again to Fedor Bank. Next, we have our Channel Innovation Award category. We received 64 nominations from companies that have made significant changes or improvements within their distribution network. Here are the finalists.
The Channel Innovation Award finalists are Bank Millennium SA, Next Gen Omnichannel Banking Platform. Bank Millennium created the Sales Channels Integration, also known as the Omnichannel Project, to enable the entire bank to make a successful digital bank transformation. The Omnichannel Project has allowed Bank Millennium to fully implement end-to-end cash loan disbursement process across digital banking, mobile app, and ATM channels, resulting in an increase in digital channel sales by 200%, an increase in cash loan conversions by 50%, and an increase in digital banking cash loan sales by 30%. The Bank of East Asia Limited for Digital Branch. To appeal to young tech-savvy consumers and to perfect its omni-channel offerings, the Bank of East Asia Limited, BEA, has launched a highly flexible and mobile digital branch that operates as a paperless straight-through model. It is equipped with a suite of innovative next-generation banking tools developed in-house at BEA, which use advanced technology to streamline services and improve efficiency. The new digital branches have yielded an increase in deposit balance per customer of 35% and have seen a 65% increase in average mortgage drawdown compared to other branches. Finansbank for Basemap. Finansbank developed Basemap to increase bank branch effectiveness. The Basemap interface allows relationship managers, RMs, to function as mobile branches with access to all Turkish market space and custom-tailored actions from a single tablet. Basemap has enabled Finansbank to extend its small-medium enterprise, SME, and commercial banking branches beyond fixed physical locations. This has improved marketing efficiency by sixfold, increased cross-selling by 24%, and raised customer acquisition by 3%, which is five times more than before. Hello Bank by BNP Paribas. Developed by BNP Paribas, Hello Bank is the first full-service European bank designed and developed specifically for mobile and tablet use. Hello Bank provides customers with intuitive and easy-to-use applications that enable quick and effective daily banking, as well as additional services and tools to help customers manage their finances. Customers have the option of interacting with the Hello Bank's team of experts either through email, chat, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, or by phone to the dedicated Hello Bank call centers. Hello Bank has been created in less than 7 months in 4 countries. And within the 18 months of operations, it has acquired 800,000 customers in 4 countries. Odia Bank for Project Unique. Odia Bank launched Project Unique to provide a true omni-channel experience by introducing a new mobile banking application for all operating systems. The scope of Project Unique included building a digital design guideline, redesigning internet banking, ATM banking, and self-service banking services, as well as developing a brand new mobile application and modifying IVR. In the first 5 months, Odia Bank achieved 55,000 mobile application downloads, received a 4.5-star average rating for iOS and a 4.1-star average rating for Android. The bank has also recorded 35,000-plus unique customer logins, 500,000-plus transactions, and 7,500-plus new online account credit card loan applications.
Right, and the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Channel Innovation Award goes to the Bank of East Asia Limited from Hong Kong. I would like to invite Adrian Lee, Deputy Chief Executive, the Bank of East Asia on stage to accept his award.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of BAI, thank you for this award. I'm delighted to be able to share this success with the team back in Hong Kong, who have worked extremely hard to make the digital branch a reality in record time. Above all, I believe this project proves that the bank branch can be revolutionized. Processes can be modernized, efficiency can be improved, customer service can be enhanced, and branches can be have a completely new look and feel. We will expand the digital branch model across our network, and I'm convinced that many aspects can be applied in other regions and even other industries. Thank you again. This event has been an eye-opener for us and a fantastic opportunity to learn and share innovation. I look forward to seeing all of you next year. Thank you.
Great. Congratulations again to the Bank of East Asia Limited. Great job. Our next award is the Innovation and Internal Process Improvement. We received 35 nominations from organizations that have made significant investments in internal process improvement to benefit the organization and ultimately the customer. Let's take a look at our finalists.
The finalists for the Innovation and Internal Process Improvement are the Bank of East Asia Limited for iKit. Designed in-house by the team at the Bank of East Asia Limited, the iKit is a one-stop financial services platform on an iPad, which enables customers to learn about banking products, make choices, and go straight to an electronic application process that is simple, efficient, and reliable. This platform has enabled bank employees to improve service efficiency and reduce waiting time, allowing customers to open a new account within 15 minutes or apply for a credit card within 5 minutes. BECU for converting transaction data with an ATM channel. Acknowledging that the ATM has become the teller of the bank with an average of 7,200 transactions per ATM a month, BECU implemented a real-time transaction monitoring and customer analytics software to gain insight on where, when, and how members interact with their ATM channel. The enhancements have enabled BECU to improve processes such as real-time alerts that identify issues in a timely manner and reduce resolution time at specific ATMs. Other enhancements include lost opportunity measurement, insight on negative member experience, and streamlined reporting processes that capture information in a more effective manner. CaixaBank or FinApps Community. CaixaBank launched FinApps Community to connect talent and ideas from CaixaBank customers with professionals from the mobile sector, customers can access the FinApps community platform to submit ideas and suggestions for improvement on existing CaixaBank mobile apps or new applications. Members of the professional mobile sector are able to register and propose project suggestions to the bank, as well as review customer ideas and transform them into mobile app projects. The FinApps community has currently reached 1,300 registrations to the platform, 58 ideas published, and 40 project proposals from clients. Denise Bonk for Powerful Teller Dashboard. Denise Bonk developed Powerful Teller Dashboard to place greater emphasis and importance on the customer experience at every contact point. The platform aligns customer relationship management strategies, predictive analytics and data mining analytics with a user-friendly, intelligent interface. The dashboard consolidated screens and workflows, as well as streamlined operational processes to enable tellers to access the information they require promptly while providing consistent customer service, regardless of the banking channel the customer is using.
All right, in the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Innovation Internal Process Improvement Award goes to Denise Bonk from Turkey. I would like to invite Mehmet Emre Demir, the CRM Senior Vice President of Denise Bank, on stage to accept the award.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Denize Bank is a pace setter in Turkish banking sector for bringing innovative approach into action. We know that innovation is not only process or technology, it's also our business culture and it's coming from our DNA. Every member of Denize Bank is highly aware of the fact that innovation has always been the impulse for by becoming biggest Turkish bank. Last year, this innovative approach was rewarded with the most innovative of the year awards at BAI. And this year, we are again proud to be awarded for Teller Dashboard. I would like to thank BAI and the awards for this and the judges for this awards. And it's a great honor to accept this award on behalf of 15,000 Denize Bank employees. Thank you.
Well, congratulations again to Denize Bank. Our next award represents one of the new categories, innovative non-bank financial services organizations that provide financial products or services directly to the to consumers. Let's go ahead and take a look at those finalists.
The finalists for the most innovative non-bank financial services organization award are Accept Email for Accept Email consumer-centric digital bill payment. Accept Email is a new way for consumers to securely initiate a payment from an email or mobile phone. In one click, the payment is initiated without manual data entry. The instantaneously generated images convey the actual bill status and show if the consumer needs to pay, how much time before the due date, or whether the bill has been paid. Accept Email allows consumers to pay bills straight from their inbox or any device using most online payment methods. Companies that utilize Accept Email experience up to 50% quicker payments, 70% less cost, and 20% improved net promoter scores. Lending Club for Lending Club, transforming the banking system. Through its online marketplace model, Lending Club utilizes technology to match borrowers and investors and offers borrowers access to affordable credit. The fast and easy-to-use online application process allows borrower applicants to evaluate loan options in just minutes without impacting their credit score. On the other side of the marketplace, investors can quickly and easily build a portfolio that fits their investment objectives. MoneyThink for MoneyThink Mobile. MoneyThink Mobile is a social application that invites teenage and young adult users to share photos, emojis, hashtags, likes, and comments as they complete digital challenges that build healthy financial behavior. MoneyThink Mobile leverages peer relationships to help users reflect on their spending habits, avoid impulse buys, set and track their progress to financial goals, and cheer their peers on in the process. Dubbed the Instagram of money by high school users, MoneyThink Mobile has led youth to cumulatively save over $6,500 in its first year of use. Movin for Movin Financial Wellness Banking App. Movin developed a free mobile app and debit card to make saving money as easy as spending it. Users have access to a number of behavior-changing tools, such as a predictive algorithm called Spending Meter that compares the user's spending behavior each month, real-time notification called Instant Receipt that provides a summary of how much a user has spent, and automatically categorizes purchases when using the Movin debit card. Other services include MoneyPath, a graphical view of the user's predicted spends, allowing them to anticipate expenses and plan accordingly each month. Pay It Simple USA Inc. for Pay It Simple. Pay It Simple has developed a cloud-based patent-protected technology that enables consumers to purchase goods and services through interest-free installments on their existing credit cards. Consumers are empowered to better manage expenses while continuing to enjoy the benefits of their credit cards, such as mileage, cash back, and points with no additional billing cycle to manage. Travelex for Taxidia. To eliminate as much cost as possible from the process of making cash available globally, Travelex developed Taxidia that enables any cash processor to access a machine that takes manual error out of the cash process. Taxidia is the only processor in the world that can package both single and strap notes at a high output rate in any denomination and in over 80 currencies. The platform is created in line with the growth of global tourism to enable travel money providers to quickly, securely, and accurately fulfill cash demands of their growing customer base.
And the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Most Innovative Non-Bank Financial Services Organization Award goes to the Lending Club from the United States. I would like to invite Andrew Derringer, Vice President, Head of Financial Institutions Group, to the stage to accept the award.
First of all, I'd like to thank BAI for honoring us for this award. It's an exciting category, and I think it's an exciting time to be part of financial services. There is a lot of new technology out there that is changing the way that we bank. Lending Club, for those that don't know, is the world's largest credit marketplace. What we've done is we've leveraged technology to more efficiently allocate capital in the financial services industry. We're bringing borrowers and investors together. And our mission is simple. We want to transform the banking industry. Maybe not too simple. But what we think is the most effective way to do that is actually transforming the banking industry inside it. And so my job at Lending Club is really to look for strategic partners in the banking industry to really find banks that want to leverage the marketplace to, one, grow, and two, offer customers a really great product. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Our next award is the Innovation in Societal and Community Impact Award. We received 21 nominations from financial services organizations that have designed or enhanced products or services or provided channel accessibility for customers in need of specialized services. Let's take a look at those finalists now.
The finalists for Innovation in Societal and Community Impact Award are CaixaBank for Infamilia Multi-Estrella Community,
InFamilia Multi-Australia Community by CaixaBank was developed on a vertical social network for customers to access free of charge and create their family within the community platform. The family space can be accessed by invitation only from the creator of the space and can be extended to either CaixaBank customers or non-customers. Within the space, members are able to interact with each other as well as share images, wish lists, and more. By providing access to non-bank customers, it not only creates visibility of CaixaBank's innovative services to potential new customers, but also allows the bank to carry out recruitment campaigns aimed at these non-bank users. Denise Bonk for Kumsol Digital Platform for Small Enterprises and Entrepreneurs. Kumsol, developed by Denise Bonk, is a cloud-based multitasking platform for small enterprises and entrepreneurs to reap the benefits of digitalization. The platform delivers online business management tools such as contact management, cash flow tracking and reporting, inventory management, website wizard, templates and online storefront, as well as group email marketing, group SMS marketing, and social media integration and publishing. Currently operating in a closed cycle group of enterprises from all over Turkey, Kumsol is projected to reach thousands of members within a year. JSC TBC Bank for Universal Sales Agents Program. JSC TBC Bank developed and successfully launched the Universal Sales Agents Program, specifically for clients in Georgia's underbanked and underpenetrated regions. With this program, agents function as mobile bank branches by visiting clients on-site, completing and submitting loan applications through a specifically designed Android application, communicating with centralized bank offices remotely, and approving loans and other products without the clients having to physically visit a branch. As of Q2 2015, the portfolio has reached 16.7 million GEL with 5x increase in interest, fee, and commission income, reaching 1.7 million GEL. Nusinda Credit Union for Co-op Capital. Nusinda Credit Union created Co-op Capital, a collaborative financial product that combines micro-lending and community sponsors to widen access to capital usually out of reach for low-income entrepreneurs. Member organizations such as co-ops, unions, or associations sponsor a loan on behalf of one of their member affiliates. Nusinda Credit Union anticipates originating at least 50 new loans in the next fiscal year to this target population.
Right, in the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Innovation and Societal and Community Impact Award goes to Nusinda Credit Union from the United States. I would like to invite Terry Laudick, President and CEO of Nusinda Credit Union, to accept his award.
Well, thank you to BAI and Infosys Finical for this award and recognition, especially in this marketplace and industry where innovation is so closely associated with the digital world. To actually have an opportunity to innovate products where it's truly about the real banking of yesteryear. So on behalf of my 450 associates, it's feet on the streets, handshakes and smiles, out listening to our members and our residents and our communities about not only what they think they need, but anticipating what they mean and delivering on those products. We're very pleased to be recognized and thank you.
Congratulations again. A lot of inspiring, I think, nominations within that category. It's so great to see, you know, the greater good that happens in the community within that category. So congratulations. Another one of our new categories that I mentioned at the opening of our program is the Innovation and Payments Award. Certainly a very prominent area for a lot of disruptive innovation within financial services. And this award is obviously recognizing all the changes that are happening within that space that are benefiting both the merchant and the consumer. So let's take a look at those nominations now.
The finalists for the Innovation and Payments Award are
CaixaBank for contactless bracelet. CaixaBank launched an open-loop Visa bracelet that enables users to make easy payments with a simple tap of their wrist. Customers are able to carry payment card information on their bracelet to make fast and convenient payments and ATM withdrawals at more than 500,000 merchants across Spain. To complement the contactless bracelet, CaixaBank created an exclusive new mobile app to allow users to manage the key functionalities of the product and receive push notifications. Currently, more than 50,000 customers of CaixaBank are using the bracelet on a daily basis on all purchases or ATM withdrawals. And more than 1,500 customers contract a new contactless bracelet weekly. Fedor Bank AG for crypto-oriented account features. Fedor Smart Current account holders can now trade Bitcoin securely and quickly, thanks to the partnership between Fedor Bank and Bitcoin.de. By removing the risk of fraud and foreign market uncertainties when trading Bitcoin, Fedor Bank customers' money are always kept in their own bank account, which is legally protected up to 100,000 euro per individual customer. With the implementation of the Ripple protocol at Fedor Bank, customers can now make global financial transactions in all sizes within seconds that is independent of the currency with no concerns of chargebacks. Customers also pay a flat fee of only 0.49 euros per transaction, regardless of destination. IdeaBank SA for the mobile ATM service for small, medium enterprises. IdeaBank SA launched a secure multifunctional mobile ATM and depository service housed in an electric BMW i3 car driven by trained bank employees, which is offered free of charge for the bank's small medium enterprises customers. Through a dedicated mobile app, customers can search for the nearest vehicle and designate a time and location for the vehicle to meet them or make an advanced booking. The built-in real-time tracking system on the app allows customers to track the vehicle and meet it at the designated location. In the vehicle, they are able to withdraw or deposit cash with all operations synced to their accounts within a few minutes.
The 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Innovation and Payments Award goes to IdeaBank from Poland. Unfortunately, IdeaBank could not be with us today, but they do have a video message that they will be sharing.
Hi, I'm Aneta, and I work for Idera Bank in Poland. I regret not being able to join you in Vegas tonight, but as you see, we are pretty busy here collecting cash from our customers and entrepreneurs using our mobile ATM. Here is another order from one of our customers, cafe owner, and I would like to use this few minutes to send my warmest greetings to you. We serve our customers on a daily basis, serving thousands of customers and driving hundreds of kilometers every single day. Thanks to those visits, we know our customers pretty well, and that's why, should you ever make it in Warsaw, we will be happy to show you where you could have a fancy haircut or a cup of aromatic coffee or the party in the evening. We would like to thank all of you for a tough competition. We are delighted we've managed, and take care and good luck.
How about that for an innovative acceptance speech from their innovation? So kind of cool. But congratulations to IdeaBank again. So now I'd like to shift into the presentation of our overall winners in a couple different categories, starting with the Disruptive Innovation in Banking Award. As our judges took a look at the five categories that we just presented, they looked for nominations that were truly game changers, redefining business as usual within retail banking. So let's take a look at those finalists right now.
The finalists for the Disruptive Innovation in Banking Award are CaixaBank for Infamilia Multi Estrella Community. Inspired by the rise of niche social networks, CaixaBank developed Infamilia Multi Estrella Community, a vertical social network for families. The community platform has proven to be a great customer loyalty tool, as it provides customers with a sense of security and privacy to interact freely with the people they choose.
key to its innovation is that CaixaBank customers can invite non-bank customers to their family. Current customers act as ambassadors of the brand, bringing people close to them into the space where they can see the advantages the bank's customers enjoy. Denise Bonk for Coomsol, digital platform for small enterprises and entrepreneurs. Denise Bonk created Coomsol, a cloud-based multitasking platform, to shift the benefits of digitalization in favor of small enterprises and entrepreneurs. Coomsol has disrupted the status quo with a digital ecosystem where small and micro businesses control their own destiny and compete successfully, gaining advantages that big corporations already enjoy. Currently, Coomsol is operating in a closed cycle group of enterprises from all over Turkey. However, Coomsol is projected to reach thousands of members within a year. Fedor Bank AG for Fedor Smart Current Account. The true disruption of the Fedor Smart Current Account is based on the Fedor operating system, a modular banking, payment, and community software developed by Fedor Techs AG. With this approach, Fedor Bank not only provides financial services that primarily have only been available to large companies or other banks, but is opening up these financial services for the entire industry. The FOS used by Fedor Bank is also in strong demand from other companies as a white label solution that can be configured to their individual specifications, thus providing Fedor Bank with an additional revenue stream. Odea Bank for Project Unique. Taking a comprehensive approach to omni-channel experience, Odea Bank launched Project Unique in 2015 that introduced a new mobile banking application for all operating systems and unified the customer experience across all direct banking channels. Each and every transaction flow is designed from top to bottom with a user-friendly approach. The initial impact of the launch of Project Unique has resulted in Odea Bank gaining competitive advantage, efficient processes and employee satisfaction, high engagement through digital channels, and lower operational cost.
Right, and the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Disruptive Innovation in Banking Award goes to Fedor Bank from Germany. Please welcome back Carson Liu, Vice President of Fedor Group International, to accept this award.
Thank you all for being here today, and of course, thanks to the judges for this great award. There have been a lot of exciting categories presented today, but for us, this is one of the most exciting. We've seen a lot of headlines recently about disruption in the areas of banking and finance. Some of them have been pretty exciting. Unfortunately, most of them have not. I think the video pretty much covered everything I was going to say, but I think I'd like to just touch on one point, which is our integration with the Ripple protocol. We were the first bank in the world to do so, and we're pretty excited about this development. Although we're just at the beginning of something pretty exciting with it, we think that virtual currencies such as the Ripple protocol offer a really exciting alternative to the traditional payment system. And I think we can all agree that the traditional payment system tends to be pretty slow, cost-intensive, and a little bit out of date. With Ripple, as the video pointed out, you can make seamless financial transactions of any size in almost instantly and virtually free of cost. So we intend to explore the opportunities in this market to help shape the future of payments. We're initially focusing our efforts on Germany in the medium term, but we'd like to expand beyond that in the upcoming months. Our September launch in the UK was a success, and we believe that the American banking customer would appreciate the innovations that we're developing at Fedor as well. So we hope to see you all very soon. Thank you very much.
Now the most innovative community-based banking award. This is another one of our new awards that was designed specifically to recognize organizations with less than $10 billion in assets that are creating products, making investments, and delivering services to meet their community's unique needs. Let's take a look at these finalists now.
The finalists for the most innovative community-based banking organization award are Bank Millennium SA. Bank Millennium created the Sales Channels Integration, also known as the Omnichannel Project. Launching the Omnichannel Project was an organizational change that paved the way for a culture of innovation across all units within Bank Millennium. The way the project was delivered has created a blueprint for consistent multi-channel innovation readiness and a base for future complex changes. At Bank Millennium, the innovation efforts are focused on delivering value to customers. Innovation hubs have been catered in two areas, A, digital, and B, processes and operations. From these areas, the innovation process is spreading across the bank and spearheading the bank's target of converting every employee into a source of innovation. Bank Smart by FM Bank PBP SA. With no branches and offering full-scale service, BankSmart is the first bank to provide a single financial service both in Poland and the Eurozone. BankSmart aims to be a breakthrough innovation which fundamentally changes the operational mode of a retail bank in the European market, therefore creating added value and a unique experience for individual customers and micro entrepreneurs. New BankSmart products and processes are inspired by new technologies, the emergence of the mobile generation, and the dynamically changing global market. BankSmart was also set up to mirror the structure of a Silicon Valley startup, which provides the bank the freedom to think outside the traditional banking schemes and existing paths. JSC TBC Bank for Universal Sales Agents Program, serving the underbanked. JSC TBC Bank successfully launched the Universal Sales Agents Program, specifically for clients in underbanked and underpenetrated regions of Georgia. While the products sold through the program are largely universal for micro-business owners, the delivery channel is unprecedented for the target segment and rebranding its retail offering. The bank created a groundbreaking setup for the bank-customer relationship and used special queuing technology to improve the customer experience. The first to offer and promote innovative e-banking services in the country, TBC Bank changed the way Georgians bank. Nusenda Credit Union. Nusenda Credit Union is firmly established as a progressive, nationally recognized cooperative organization energized by innovation, committed to its community, and determined to achieve greater impact. Nusenda operates and supports various programs in the community, including serving as a lead partner in developing new access points to capital and embedding financial literacy into a robust entrepreneurship and innovation effort being undertaken by the City of Albuquerque.
And the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Most Innovative Community Banking Organization Award goes to Nusenda Credit Union from the United States. Please welcome Terry Laudick back to the stage.
Thank you again. I must say that I might have to enlighten you a little more on what it is that we do and who we are, because again, our innovation doesn't have this sexy appeal of the digital world, but we are a credit union in New Mexico, which has the second largest number of residents living in poverty. And yet while the digital world is sexy, we do still offer all of those same services. We do have mobile banking, we do have internet banking, we have video teller operations and such, and we are reaching all populations throughout the state of New Mexico. But we have within our mission to provide the convenience and access of technology today with a commitment to the personal banking of yesteryear. So we are focusing with full resource on being out there helping the underbanked and the underserved and helping our micro entrepreneur community and also our students. We believe that providing the product and the service in of itself only meets the need for now, and that there's a demand for us to also be responsible for educating on real use of financial products to create a better economic opportunity for our residents. Thank you again for this recognition.
Congratulations again, Terry. It's such a great reminder that innovation doesn't always have to be centered around technology, that just making a significant impact within your community can also be the cornerstone of innovation. So congratulations. All right, are we ready for our final marquee award? To determine the 2015 winner of the Most Innovative Bank of the Year award, the judging panel reviewed both the quantity and quality of all the nominations that were submitted from each organization. Judges were also provided with some additional information about each organization in terms of how they support and demonstrate a culture of innovation. This year, the judges picked finalists that were considered the best of the best from regions they represent. Let's take a look at those finalists right now.
The finalists for the Most Innovative Bank of the Year award are the Bank of East Asia Limited. The Bank of East Asia Limited has a long tradition of innovation. Dating as far back as 1969, BEA was one of the first Chinese banks in Hong Kong to introduce advanced technology to their operations with the installation of a state-of-the-art computer system. Always striving to provide best-in-class financial services, BEA upholds five core values: professionalism, customer focus, integrity, progressiveness, and innovation. This ethos is the foundation stone on which the culture of innovation within BEA is built, and over the years has enabled BEA to hold a strong track record as a market leader and pioneer in online banking. Denise Bach. A strong commitment and focus from the upper management of Denise Bach has enabled the bank to cultivate a robust innovation culture across the organization. Denise Bach's first-of-its-kind digital generation banking department contributes to the digital evolution of not only Denise Bach, but the Turkish financial sector by focusing, discovering, and implementing new technologies and unique financial experiences. Denise Bank's innovative culture is going back a long way to the establishment of its own technology company, Intertech. Intertech provides banks in the Middle East and Europe with banking technology services. Fedor Bank AG. Munich-based Fedor Bank is the first Web 2.0 bank in Germany. Founded in the upheaval of the financial crisis, Fedor Bank has made a deliberate choice in favor of social banking and symbolizes a countermodel to conventional banking with openness, transparency, and client participation. With the motto, Pirates of Banking, innovative software developers from the international financial industry have gathered under the roof of Fedor Bank AG in London, Moscow, and Munich to work together with fintech solutions on the subject of banking. With these developer events, the bank offers a look at attractive future solutions and is stimulating discussions about new possibilities in order to turn the future of banking inside out. Nusenda Credit Union. Nusenda Credit Union is firmly established as a progressive, nationally recognized cooperative organization, energized by innovation, committed to its community, and determined to achieve greater impact. The largest credit union in the state of New Mexico by membership, Nusenda's mission is to be a trusted financial resource by serving as the financial institution of yesterday with all the convenience, technology, and accessibility of today and tomorrow. In creating and supporting a culture of innovation, Nusenda operates and supports various programs in the community.
We'd like to recognize our finalists and present them with their finalist awards on stage. Representing Asia, Adrian Lee, Bank of East Asia Limited.
Just do a
Representing Europe, we have Richard Bellecci from Fidor Bank. Actually, Karsten Luths, sorry about that. Representing the Middle East and Africa, we have Gurhan Kam from Deniz Bank. And finally, representing the Americas, Terry Laudick from Nucenda Credit Union. How about one more round of applause for all of our regional finalists? Great work, great innovations. All right, I think we need a drum roll. Are we ready for the final award? Thank you very much. So upon final deliberations, and again, thank you so much to our judges for all their work here, I'm very proud to present the 2015 BAI Infosys Finical Most Innovative Bank of the Year Award to the Bank of East Asia Limited from Hong Kong.
On behalf of our bank, thank you very much for this prestigious award. I mean, it's like a Christmas day to us. I feel very fortunate to be involved in the bank in banking innovation during such exciting time for the industry. This conference demonstrates the great developments that are already underway, and I have no doubt that we will see even more significant changes ahead. At BEA, we are now in the process of digitalizing our entire service network. Our true omni-channel platform will provide a consistently excellent experience at every touch point. And through these efforts, we aim to deliver enhanced market-leading services that cater to the ever-changing needs of our customers. Thank you again for this tremendous honor. This is an exceptional forum for learning and discussion. And I know that we will be taking home a great deal of knowledge and insight along with this magnificent award. I look forward to seeing what the future holds for banking, and I can assure you that BEA will continue to drive innovation forward. Thank you very much.
Well, congratulations again to all of our finalists and the winners, and thank you so much for participating in today's awards program. I hope that these winning institutions have inspired you to challenge your own organizations to make smart business decisions to foster innovation. You can get to know our winners and our finalists a little better and learn more about their innovations at some of the programming that we have that's coming up and later on in BAI Retail Delivery. You can see those right there, thank you. And we also look forward to recognizing and celebrating innovations next year when we gather together back in Chicago for BAI Retail Delivery 2016. And the call for nominations for 2016 will open up just shortly after the year. So really encourage you to submit, you know, all those wonderful innovations again. So now I hope that you'll stay. We have a little reception in the back of the room, and we'd love to toast with some champagne all of our wonderful winners and really celebrate innovation together. Thank you so much.